Body is generally complete. Now it's time to move on to the head. With the head, I also start with cylinders. I'm gonna create two cylinders and position one cylinder over the eye and one cylinder over the mouth. And the subdivisions for these cylinders are somewhat important. We wanna make sure that whatever subdivision number that we choose, we get a general match between the two sets of cylinders. So the one cylinder sits over the eye, the other cylinder sits over the mouth. In this case, I've used eight subdivisions around the eye and 12 subdivisions around the mouth. And then I delete the faces, the side of the cylinder and the back of the cylinder, so that I'm left with only the cap faces. And I reshape these cap faces to fit the face. And I start with a single subdivision and then I can subdivide. And with the eye, I'm using the outermost row to represent the ocular orbit. And then the innermost row represents the outer edge of the eyeball. And I just wanna make sure that I have sort of an outwards motion with the ocular orbit, and then the eye is recessed inwards. So similar with the mouth, I have two rows. The inner row becomes the lips. The outer row becomes the laugh line. And I do want to watch the quads in this area. With the mouth, I connect straight up and down from the top of the lip to the bottom of the lip. This gives me nice quads. And I do something similar with the eye as well. So we get rid of those triangles that are in the center of the mouth and the eye. We have nice quads. So I'm reshaping the face parts to suit my reference. Typically, you want to use reference that is as high resolution as possible, and you want to pay as much attention as possible to matching up the shapes. In this case, I'm just winging it, so I'm not too worried about my reference. And now you can see that I've reshaped that outer row on the mouth to adjust to the shape of the laugh line around the mouth. Now I'm adding a second row in between the mouth and the laugh line, and this will be the basis for the nose. So I take that top face that I've just created and extrude it straight out, and then I take the face on top and extrude that straight up. That becomes the bridge of the nose. Be careful to delete those interior polygons. I'll reshape these verts, and I'm just creating a very, very basic nose. I'll be adding detail via sculpt later, so I'm not at all concerned with trying to represent accurate nose shape. I'm much more concerned with getting a topology that will work for animation, which means lots of nice quads. So the real challenge here is the corner of the nose, and how do we connect the eyes to the mouth and nose area without creating a bunch of triangles. So if I extrude straight down and out from the eye, we'll see that it merges very nicely to the bridge of the nose, but now I'm left with what is obviously a triangle, and I can try and extrude out, and when I merge those two together, I see that I'm left with that triangle. So extruding straight out from the eyeball is not exactly what I want to do. I will extrude down, and I'm gonna basically move that triangle up, and we'll see that it's up by the eye, and I'm gonna leave extra space in this area, so that gap that sits right there, I'm gonna fill that in, and now I've got two triangles back to back, which is a quad. So I've got my triangles in that region solved. So the hard part is over. We've got the corner of the nose with the laugh line connected, and that connection is important. We need a geometry line that agrees with the laugh line so that when I start deforming, I can create shapes like grimaces and smiles. Now I can extrude out around the mouth and use those extra faces to start to define the chin and cheek area. So I'll push in under the mouth and start to define that negative area value under the mouth. And I do want to make sure to smooth out verts in the region to make sure that I'm getting a nice smooth flow. When I'm happy with the shapes, I can extrude outwards. And again, I'm focused on the jaw, chin, cheek area. So these verts are pushing back. And we do want to note that the face is very flat on the front of the face and it's very long along the side. So as I get closer to the edge of the face, I'm pulling my verts farther and farther back. So these verts that I've extruded out, I'm putting those at the edge of the face, and we have to pull them back fairly far in the side view to get them to line up. And I'll end up with this shape here. I've got a nice group of quads and the shape of the jaw defined. Right now the shape of the jaw is a little big, so I have to remove some volume from her face by pushing a few verts in the cheek and chin area inwards towards the center so that I'm removing volume and I'm kind of smoothing things out. At this point, the chin and the cheek are relatively done. The eye, the nose, the mouth are in place. So I can turn my attention to the rest of the head. And I'll start by extruding upwards from the top of the eye area. And I'll pull those verts up and out to meet the hairline. This is going to be the extents of the forehead. And these verts don't come straight up. We push them out a little bit so that we get kind of a fanning out of those verts. I'll deal with these excess faces in the center of the nose in a minute. But first I add another row and I just use that to push out the forehead to create some roundness. And again, the verts at the edge of the face are being pushed to the furthest extremes of the face. I want to make sure that I'm defining the entire face. I'll tackle the rest of the head with the skull object. So those extra faces in between the nose there, we really don't need those and they're going to cause problems in the forehead. So I'm just going to triangle them off in the middle and then extrude into the center of the forehead to meet those two points. When I add those verts, I'll move the other verts out of the way a little bit just so that they're not crowding those new verts that I've added. And now I've got a pretty good face mask. So I'm ready to move on to creating the rest of the head shape. Okay, the head. We do start with a sphere for the head. We want to be careful though. I'm going to turn the sphere on its side so that the poles are facing horizontally instead of vertically. And I'll adjust the subdivisions to 12 so they're degrees with my head a little bit more. And then I'm going to spend time placing it. So the head is narrower in the front than it is in the back. So I'm going to grab a few faces and shrink them in. The sides of the head are a lot more flat than round, so I'll push those in. And the back of the head is a little bit wider, so I can grow that just a little bit. And I'll get rid of faces around the face. And this will leave me with kind of a Pac-Man looking shape. And I can just snap the verts from the skull object onto the verts of the face. And we should get a pretty nice matchup between the two. I'm gonna drag my faces on the skull all the way down to the base of the chin. Eventually, we're gonna fill in that area with the neck, but for right now, I'm just gonna close it off. Now it's time to add yet another cylinder. This one is gonna be the ear. A lot more flexible on this one. Ear doesn't need to be very precise. I'll cut the cap off. It's got 8 subdivisions. And in the side view, I'll just reshape it to the side of the ear. And because I'm not getting a good agreement between my front and my side views, I'll defer to the front view for the shape of the ear as far as placement in 3D. And I do want to tilt the ear so that it's closer to the skull at the front of the ear, and it tilts out away from the skull at the back of the ear. But it's a pretty simple oval shape, and I'll extrude that straight out. And that extrusion, I will scale flat. And this is gonna be what I start to connect to the head. I'll adjust a little bit of the shape here. I do want to keep the ear totally flat where it meets the face, but the back of the ear doesn't need to be as flat, so I'm not as concerned with the shape of the back of the ear as I am with the front. So I'll extrude straight out from it, and I'll just create a flat patch. And these are going to be verts that I connect into the side of the head. And I'll just snap to the points that I've got. And in this case, I got pretty lucky with the 8 subdivisions. It matches the head pretty nicely. So I can combine those two and merge them together. And there's a little bit of a problem with the shape under the ear, but we'll probably resolve that once we add the neck. So at this point, I've got a face, I've got a skull, there's an ear. Now I'm ready to deal with the neck connection. Now I do have a neck on the body. It's already been extruded out. So I'm gonna focus on connecting the skull to that neck. And I'm gonna start by taking the points at the bottom of the skull and just snapping them very literally to the neck. I'm not real concerned about shape yet. All I want to do is create a nice set of quads connecting the head and the skull to the neck. So I'll focus on the shape first. I'll focus on the topology first, and then I'll deal with the shape. So that leaves us with this shape with a very spiky looking chin. I'm just merging the verts here so that I have a solid mesh. And then I'll turn my attention to the shape of the head. And I'll add some subdivisions under the chin. And I'm using my split polygon tool here simply to cut in some extra edges that I can pull down and out. And if we look at our side view reference, we'll see that the transition from her chin to her neck is a lot softer, and it's also a lot more downwards facing. Whereas my chin is super, super sharp, and it's pointed up much too high. So I'll resolve part of that by connecting the body to the head and merging those verts between the head and the neck. And now I am just going to use this side view reference a little bit more literally for placement of the head. So I check the reference in the side view, and I can pull those verts in the jaw and the neck area downwards to create that nice soft transition from chin to neck. Now the head and the body are merged together. I'll clean up some triangles on the head by just deleting those edges. It'll leave me with quads. And now I can start adjusting the body as a whole. So in this case, the neck is too long, so I'll move the head downwards a little bit. I can see that there's some mismatches between my reference and the body mesh, and I'll just push and pull verts to correct the shape. The issue that I'm running into is when I smooth the mesh, we're gonna lose volume every time we smooth it. Things will become a little bit softer looking, so we have to model specifically to create the proper shape when it's smoothed. At this point, it's time to combine the two halves of the body, so I'll do that, and now I need to merge the verts in the center. Quick way to do that is to just select the edge rings in the center of the body and scale them against each other so that they're perfectly flat. Now I can convert that to vert mode and use my merge verts. Now that the mesh is basically done, I'll spend the rest of the time polishing it. So, for example, the chin is pushed a little bit too far forward. I'll use my soft selection tool to push that out. There's a little bit too much of a bump in the cheek, so I'll flatten that out. Merge the pants together to create a single mesh. And then combine everything together. And the last change that I'll make is to the shape of the head. She looks like a cone head, so I'll just use my soft select and push and pull to create more of a natural skull shape. And with that, we're done. We've got a relatively well topologized base mesh that is ready for the next step, be it sculpting or texturing. And that's it. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, you can find more like it at my website, methodj.com.